Massey winds up for his first pitch of the day. And it's in there for a strike off the foul tip. Senior out of Tallahassee, this one's grounded right up the middle and it'll be a base hit. There goes the no-hitter for Michael Massey. Massey got him on the breaking ball. Check swing, he went. Strikeout number one for Massey. He's in an 0-2 count, Massey delivers. Strikeout number two.
Corey was a tremendous player.
That one looks like it plunked off the third baseman, Mason Dobie. And he'll take a base. Fastball got him. Strikeout number three on the day for Michael Massey.
Expanding his arsenal is a key for him this year.
6'5" righty delivers right down the middle with some heat at 93. That's strikeout number four. He's got a 1-2 count though. This one smacked into right field. It will drop for a base hit. Jake Reinisch is aboard with a single. Densmore pitch number 16. This one's fair and down the third baseline for a base hit. Reinisch is going to round second, head to third. Ballesteros going to head to second himself. That's a stand-up double for Tate Ballestero. And Hawks sends this one into left center. That'll drive in a run. Wake Forest is on the board first. Reinisch will score. Ballestero rounding third. Two doubles in a row makes it 2-0 Wake. And Winnae sends this one down left, just foul. Tommy Hawk, some very productive season over in Cleveland. With no men away, 270, I want to say, if my math. Densmore on the 1-2. And this one's hit hard to left center field by Winnae. Goodbye, two-run shot, Jack Winnae. 4-0 lead for the Deeks.
That's big boy country out there. You get in the left center field starting to get towards the batting eye and hit that far over the bushes. That's legit. Well struck.
Winnae's second homer of the year gives Wake a 4-0 lead, doubles their lead, drives in Hawk, never in doubt.
Short and quick and gone in a hurry.
This one's well hit and fair down the third baseline for a base hit from Eric Houston. Rounding first, gonna go to second. Stand up double. Wake Forest, when it rains, it pours. And that's a walk. Men on the corners. Packard, the 6'3" senior, will deliver the 1-1. In the dirt and behind Nolan Watson. Here comes Houston home. The play at home, not in time. That'll be run number five for Wake. Also in the dirt, good stop this time by Watson. It's gonna be a walk. Grounder to short, Omar Daniels to second. That's one to first, and that is what Dayton needed desperately to get out of the inning. Nick Wisman comes in. Big swing, and that's a real quick strikeout for Michael Massey. 39, excuse me. That's a big swing for strikeout number six on the day. We'll allow it.
He was due, you know?
Massey got him, breaking ball. Gill to clean it up. One away. Dayton team both offensively and defensively. Strikes out. 93 on the gun for Massey. 2-2. This one's hit deep to left. Well hit by Mendez. And gone over the left field wall. Dayton gets one back. Massey riding the hot streak of three straight strikeouts. Just left that one over the bag and Mendez took care of it. Did that one hit him? Take your base, he was hit. Massey got him. Off speed 79. Strikeout number nine. Tellier swings, 86 down the middle. Well, he just plays that level of maturity that we were talking about as he smacks this one up center for a base hit. There's that first hit since Friday that we were looking for Nick Kurtz. Kurtz tries to steal second, the throw from Watson, not in time.
That's really close.
Hit deep to left center. No chance this stays in the ballpark. Goodbye, two-run shot, Seaver King, 7-1 Wake. Two home runs in two games for the junior transfer. Wake Forest fans rise to their feet.
coaching staff has said repeatedly, if there's one thing you don't worry about, it's whether or not this guy's going to hit. And the two home runs in 2 days.
And he's got his first strikeout of the game. Got him looking. And the off-speed gets him. Two batters face, two strikeouts for the freshman. Guthrie on the 1-2. Tap to Austin Hawk. Three up, three down with two Ks for Josh Guthrie. Freshman stepping in for Michael Massey. Ballestero, first pitch, takes him left for a single.
That's a Wake Forest continuing their aggressiveness.
Payoff to Hawk. Got him. 90 on the gun. First strikeout of the day for Tran. Ballestero again, just a slight lead. This time, Tran will deliver and get him. Two strikeouts already for Aiden Tran. Tran on the 1-2. Got him. Three strikeouts for Aiden Tran. The freshman showing his stuff.
Top 10. We'll see how much it gets shaken up.
Outside, so Koshy can't. Watson is aboard. Mendez hits this one to right, and it's going to bounce for a base hit. Reinisch couldn't get there in time. Runner advances. So Mendez, 2 for 2 with a home run and a single. 2-2. Nelson got him. 92 mile an hour heater. His first strikeout of the day. And he'll take a walk. First walk on the day allowed by Aiden Tran, the freshman. Well hit to left center field for a base hit by Tellier. Houston will go to second. Tran's got Kurtz in a quick 0-2 count. Got him looking. Breaking ball 82 in the zone. Big strikeout for the freshman. Seaver King at bat. Hits this one high to center. Not deep enough, though. Alejandro Cazorla is under it. Houston tags second, as well as Tellier from first. The play at second is not in time. Runners advance. Big swing. And how about Aiden Tran? Striking out Nick Kurtz, striking out Jake Reinisch. He's got 5 on the day. 2 hits, no earned runs to his name thus far today. And he strikes out Tate Ballestero. There's a 5-pitch walk. Lifted high and deep to center. Casorla's backing up. He's at the warning track. It's off the wall and gone. 2-run shot for Jack Winnay.
That ball may have hit the top of the wall, then bounced off the batting eye, then come back in. The call was made by first base umpire David Brown, waving the arms overhead. And what did it do?
From here, we're about 450 feet away. It looked like it landed just above that yellow line, which indicates whether or not the ball is still in play. Oh, it does hit the yellow.
Hits the yellow line and comes back, but the yellow line is out.
Johnston on the 1-2. First strikeout of the day for Zach Johnston. 81 off speed. Johnston delivers to Cazorla. Looks like it went off his foot and he's going to take a base. Top 10 all-time attended baseball games have come this season. Wake Forest really showing out. Really well hit by Nolan Watson to left center and is gone. It was an 88 mile an hour pitch hanging over the plate and Watson took it deep. So Dayton gets a couple back, 9-3 now. The score, same score as the final score yesterday.
Boy, it's amazing how quickly your fortunes can turn around in the game of baseball. You're cruising along, you're looking good, your first two hitters feeling good, getting ahead. Pitch slips away from you and you hit a guy with it, and then the next thing you know, oops, made a mistake and see ya.
Well hit right into the glove of Austin Hawk. Logan Barnett trying to end the inning. And he walks him. 88 outside. 1-2. This one's dribbling and escaping the infield for a base hit. Single for Austin Hawk.
Yeah, I was talking about this with another broadcaster from another.
Payoff pitch. Great eye by Javar Williams. Taking his time with it, not rushing into anything, and the base is loaded. Big swing, off speed, 74 breaking ball, got Cameron Gill, so a good strikeout by Logan Barnett. Here's Ryan McDougal. Well hit, high to right center, and it's gone. Ryan McDougal with his second home run in as many games. This is a solo shot over right center. Barely made it over that wall. So the freshman with a good personal series this weekend in Winston-Salem.
Went down and got what looked like a pretty good pitch.
A&T on Tuesday. As this one's well hit by Yaman for a base hit into left. This one's really well hit into left. Williams is under it, and he's not going to get it. That's a two-run shot for Michael Adair. And now hang on. No outs. And all of a sudden, Dayton's within three.
Well, that's going to have people scrambling in the bullpen very quickly. Three hitters, three runs.
See if he gets a taste of action today. Big swing by Scott. There's the first strikeout for Morningstar. Much needed. Morningstar on the 3-1. There's the walk. So that is that base runner aboard. Wake Forest fans clapping. Falco. Here's a dribbler to Houston. To second, that's one. To first, not in time. Good running by Tamaney, keeping the game alive. Falco on the 3-1. Hit well to right. Salvino is under it, and that'll do it. Falco comes in to save the day. Wake Forest walks away with his 9-6 win over Dayton and a weekend series sweep. They improve to 6-1 on the season.